Everybody, this is Sharon, and a lot of people wanted to find out, how do I go about evaluating a company? So I've come up with 10 questions on how to evaluate an online business. Some of you guys are truly taking this year to do something, to truly look for a company that you can do from home. You're missing some of your children's school events, and you're even missing some of your family events. And you're finding it truly hard to enjoy getting up, going to your job. So, but you haven't done anything. You just keep hating it and just still keep coming up. Getting up in the morning, going to that job. So I have come up with 10 questions that you can ask while you are looking at the different companies, because there are a lot of them. And the first question is it legitimate? Because there are companies out there that are not. So you look for the history of that particular company. The second question is it affordable? Nobody knows how much money you have but you, and how much money that you can afford to invest in yourself in a company but you. Number three, how many downline members will it take to earn a commission? And that is a good question, because some companies, the first person that you recruit, that is it rounds up, or it is passed up. Some companies, you keep the first person. So look into their commission plan and how their system is set up. Number four, how are the commissions paid, daily, weekly, or monthly? Because different companies pay differently. Number five, can I earn commissions again, again, and again? That is called residual income. And so you look at what is the residual income for that particular company. Number six, is it necessary to sponsor others to get a commission? And most companies are sponsors. You do have to sponsor somebody, but that's a question to ask. Number seven, will there have to be any other out-of-pocket costs other than the joining amount to join? Question to ask. A good, very good question to ask, because sometimes they tell you, oh, you could come in for XYZ, but they forget to tell you A, B, and C, right? So, number eight, are the products in-house or not? Meaning, that means when you come into a company, you are an affiliate because you did not create the products. If you create the products, then they're yours. But when you come into a company, the company gives you the ability to sell whatever products they have. And sometimes they're digital products that you can sell and resell. Sometimes they're physical products. So that's something you have to find out. What is the setup? What are you selling, and how are you selling them? Number nine, is the owner of the company good and an excellent communicator? Can you speak to the owner or the developer? Is his line of communication open? Okay. Number 10, how much training and support does the company have? And sometimes the company, there's no training. That the person who recruits you is the one who is responsible for training you. And then there's some companies that there is an abundance of training, whether that sponsor is engaging with you or not, you are still able to get all of the training that you want and need to be successful without the sponsor. So those are the 10 questions that you should ask when you are looking at a online business. So do your due diligence. Don't stop dreaming. And you keep looking until you find the right fit for you. If you want to know what I'm doing and how I'm doing it, and even why I'm doing what I'm doing, connect with me. My information is at the bottom of this video, and I look forward to hearing from you. Make 2016 your year for making your personal freedom a reality. Toodles.